Abby.
I'm Joe.
And welcome to the Kelku Review Show. Today we're going to be looking at editing apps on the iPad.
Indeed we are. Today we're going to look at iMovie and RealDirector. RealDirector works on both iPad 1 and 2, and iMovie only works on the iPad 2. So there we go. Recognise that?
What do you mean that?
So basically you get a fairly kind of standard timeline across the top where you can put more clips in, drag and drop clips in. So this is a video we took earlier on. So to edit, basically, you just tap on the video there and then you can do all sorts of stuff. You can resize it, you can trim it, you can add titles. So if I click on the trim tool, once you're in, this is actually quite easy to use.
How do you know how much you're trimming it?
See, that is the pain, because you don't.
Right.
You can kind of work out from what's on the screen, where you're moving it to.
What if you trim it and then it's wrong?
Well, if you trim it and it's wrong, you've got two options. So if you hit done, it then basically says final trim or keep original. If I hit final trim there, game over.
Game over.
If I hit keep original, then it obviously keeps the original. And then in I go. So, and then I'll play it and it'll start from whatever point I just chose. You can also add subtitles very easily, which I did just now. So this one is called Face. There it is.
So what do you think of this?
I'm quite moody.
What? No, I'm despairing. I'm despairing. Stop it.
So anyway, right. So how much how much does it cost?
£1.19.
Yeah, so it's quite cheap. I think it's a good app. It kind of does the job. It's basic, but...
So can I film on the iPad too and just drag and drop it into the app and edit it from there?
Yes. But this app doesn't have an in-app video. So you have to exit the app, go into the camcorder, film it, and then the video's on your iPad. But some of the other apps that we've looked at, you literally just hit record and it all happens in the app.
Okay.
So it's a bit more of a faff, takes a bit longer.
Okay, and can I add special effects? Can I add?
There's a few things. You can add sort of some transition style, a bit of movement, a few bits and bobs, not a huge amount. That's not really, this is more kind of for editing your film in terms of end, beginnings and stuff. Not like, you're not going to get sort of
special
some work
effects.
Of art out of it.
And what if I put it in there, I can edit it straight away?
Yep.
Or does it need to render, compress?
Oh, well, no, it does take, it does take a bit of time to render it. So you upload it.
Like,
and actually it takes a bit longer than the video takes to watch. So...
You have to wait. And then once you've done it, is it ready to, or does it have to render again? I think it has to render again.
Does it?
Yeah, I think so.
You might be right then.
Yeah.
Right, shall we move on?
Yeah.
Okay, so the next one we're going to look at is iMovie.
And this is iPad 2 specific.
Correct. Doesn't work on the iPad one.
And it's $2.99, by the way, as well.
It is. So it's a bit more expensive, right? Almost, well, in fact, more than double the price of RealDirector. So, what does it do? Again, it's fairly basic. There's nothing really that this does that is worlds apart from RealDirector. And in fact, I think some of the editing is a bit more fiddly and a bit of a faff compared to the other one. So, I know that there's about 5 seconds of dead time at the beginning of this video, and it really starts about there.
Dead time?
Yeah, you were kind of scratching your hair and blah, blah, blah. So...
I'm a professional.
So to do it,
scratching my hair.
Yeah.
Okay, so sorry,
look,
Come on.
You have to kind of move it along like that, which is a bit fiddly, isn't it? And then I have even less idea on this, where I am in the video, compared to what I did on RealDirector. So.
Okay.
There are some fine-tuning options, but the basic interface, I think, is actually a bit better on RealDirector.
And can I add any special effects, titles, different backgrounds, anything like that?
Yep, you can do more in this than you can do on RealDirector. And there are some third-party app makers who have basically built add-ons, so you can make it even better. So some of those you're going to have to pay for, but yes.
But so why isn't this one as good as RealDirector, in your opinion?
Well, I just think it's not...
Sort of seems better.
It depends what you want it for. I mean, if you want to make an actual film. So for example, this is another video clip I dropped in. So if I want to create a little transition there between these two, it's very easy to do that. You just hit that button.
Yeah,
and
I've turned into a man.
And then you fade in and there's our cameraman. So,
great.
So it's quite easy to do that sort of thing.
Yeah.
And then there's loads of effects up here.
If I've never used iMovies or RealDirector before, what's the best one for me? Like, what am I gonna go in, be able to start editing straight away, not have to faff around? Like, what's going to be best for me?
If you want to just take a video, edit it, upload it, like a single clip, I think RealDirector is actually better for editing that. if you want to create a series of videos, create an actual kind of a movie with different scenes and transitions and stuff, then I think iMovie is better.
Okay. I think iMovie is better. I get to put, pretty things in the background.
I'm trying to play with it.
I'm a bit scared it's worth a lot of money.
Thanks.